Hi, I'm Kevin Busarow with Oberwerk Binoculars, and today we're going to talk about the basic operation of the XL Series binocular telescope. This is the BT-100XL ED. I'm going to put this on our fork mount. That's centered on there. Capture it with the thumb screw. Okay, that's good. All right, first thing we need to do is remove the objective covers. Just unscrew them. We have caps, dust caps in the focusers. We're going to pull those out. And we're going to drop in our eyepieces, just like that. The upper part of the focus knob is the lock ring. So we're going to hold the lower part of the focuser and turn the upper ring clockwise, and that snugs down on the eyepiece so that it doesn't fall out. Get both sides. Okay, it's ready to go. The next thing we want to do is look through the binocular and adjust the eyepiece spacing. In the bottom of each turret, there are ridges. That's where your thumbs go, and you can push together or pull apart to get the eyepiece spacing to match your eyes. So we're just going to look through the binocular and move them together up and apart until we find that sweet spot where we have perfectly merged image right there. The eyepieces, if we're wearing glasses, we want these eyecups all the way down. If we're not wearing glasses, we can extend the eyecups by turning them counterclockwise. And this helps hold your eye at the correct position. If eyecups are down and I get in too close, the view disappears. It's called blackout. So to help prevent blackout, we can bring up these eyecups to help hold our eye at the right distance. I kind of like the halfway position, but everybody's different. So some people need these all the way up. I like them halfway down. The main thing is we want to be able to see the entire field of view without the image blacking out. So for me, the halfway position is perfect. The only other thing to know about the binocular is it has extendable glare shields, and you just slide those out like that. This can help prevent dew formation on a humid evening. It also, if you're looking at something and the moon is over here and you're looking at something over here, that can help cut glare from the moon. Likewise, if you're using it in daylight, looking out over water and there's glare, extending the glare shields can help with that too. And that's it. Thanks for watching.